Blessed is our God, always, now, and ever, and unto the ages of ages.
Amen. Glory to thee, our God, glory to thee. O heavenly King, Comforter, Spirit of Truth, Lord, everywhere present and fill us all things, Treasury of good things and giver of life, come and dwell in us and cleanse us of all impurity, and save our souls, O good one. Holy God, Holy Mighty, Holy Immortal, have mercy on us. Holy God, Holy Mighty, Holy Immortal, have mercy on us. Holy God, Holy Mighty, Holy Immortal, have mercy on us. Glory to the Father, and to the Son, and to the Holy Spirit, both now and ever, and unto the ages of ages. Amen. O most holy Trinity, have mercy on us. O Lord, blot out our sins. O Master, pardon our iniquities. O Holy One, visit and heal our infirmities, for thy name's sake. Lord, have mercy, Lord, have mercy, Lord, have mercy. Glory to the Father, and to the Son, and to the Holy Spirit, both now and ever, and unto the ages of ages. Amen. Our Father, who art in the heavens, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our debts as we forgive our debtors. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from the evil one.
Thy is the kingdom and the power and the glory of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit, now and ever, and unto the ages of ages.
Amen. Lord have mercy, 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 Lord have mercy. Glory to the Father, and to the Son, and to the Holy Spirit, both now and ever, and unto the ages of ages. Amen. O come, let us worship God our King. O come, let us worship and fall down before Christ our King and God. O come, let us worship and fall down before Christ himself, our King and God. A beloved of thy dwellings, O Lord of hosts, my soul longeth and faithful accord to the Lord. My heart and my flesh have rejoiced in the living God. For the sparrow hath found herself a house, and hath built up a nest for herself, where she may lay her young. Even thine altars, O Lord of hosts, my King and my God. Blessed are they that dwell in thy house unto the ages of ages, shall they praise thee. Blessed is the man whose help is from thee, hath made a sense in his heart in the day of weeping, in the place which he hath appointed. Yea, for the lawgiver will give blessings, they shall go from strength to strength. The God of God shall be seen in Zion. O Lord of hosts, hearken unto my prayer, give ear, O God of Jacob. O God our defender, behold, and look upon the face of thine anointed one. For better is one day in thy courts than thousands elsewhere. I have chosen rather to be an outcast in the house of my God than to dwell in the tents of sinners. For the Lord loveth mercy and truth. God will give grace and glory. The Lord will not withhold the things from them that walk in their sins. O Lord God of hosts, blessed is the man that looketh in thee. Thou hast been gracious, O Lord, unto thy land. Thou hast turned back the captivity of Jacob. Thou hast forgiven the iniquities of thy people. Thou hast covered all their sins. Thou hast made all thy wrath to cease. Thou hast turned back from the wrath of thine anger. Turn us back, O God of our salvation. Turn away thine anger from us. Hold up thy wrath with us unto the ages. O hold up all thy wrath from generation to generation. O God, thou wilt turn in quickness, and thy people shall be glad in thee. Show us, O Lord, thy mercy and thy salvation that thou give unto us. I will hear what the Lord God will speak in me, for he will speak peace to his people and to his saints, and to them that turn their hearts unto him. Surely nigh unto them that fear is his salvation, that glory may dwell in our land. Mercy and truth have met together, righteousness and peace have kissed each other. Truth is sprung up out of the earth, and righteousness have looked down from heaven. Yea, for the world will give goodness, and our land shall yield good fruit. Righteousness shall go before him, and shall set his footsteps in the way. Bow down thine ear, O Lord, and hearken unto me, for poor and needy am I. Preserve my soul, for I am holy. Save thy servant, O my God, that lifteth in thee. Have mercy on me, O Lord, for unto thee will I cry all the day long. Make glad the soul of thy servant, for unto thee have I lifted up my soul. For thou, O Lord, art good and gentle, and gracious in mercy unto all them that call upon thee. Give me, O Lord, unto my prayer, and attend unto the voice of my supplication. In the day of my affliction have I cried unto thee, for thou hast heard me. There is none like unto thee among the gods, O Lord, nor are there any words like unto thy words. All the nations that thou hast made shall come and shall worship before thee, O Lord, and shall glorify thy name. For thou art great and workest wonders, thou alone art God. Guide me, O Lord, in thy way, and I will walk in thy truth. Let my heart rejoice that I may fear thy name. I will confess thee, O Lord my God, with all my heart, and I will glorify thy name forever. For great is thy mercy upon me. Thou hast delivered my soul from the uttermost Hades. O God, transgressors have risen up against me, the assembly of the mighty had sought after my soul, and they had not set me before them. But thou, O Lord my God, art compassionate and merciful, long-suffering and plenteous in mercy and truth. Look upon me, have mercy upon me, give thy strength unto thy servant, and save the son of thy handmaiden. Work in me a sign unto the Lord, and let them that hate me behold me put to shame. For thou, O Lord, hast opened me and comforted me. Work in me a sign unto the Lord, and let them that hate me behold me put to shame. For thou, O Lord, hast opened me and comforted me. Glory to the Father, and to the Son, and to the Holy Spirit, both now and ever, and unto the ages of ages. Amen. Alleluia, 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 glory to thee, O God. Alleluia, 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 glory to thee, O God. Alleluia, 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 glory to thee, O God. What a mercy, what a mercy, what a mercy. Glory to the Father, and to the Son, and to the Holy Spirit. Great is the wonder of faith, the seven holy youths have broken the cables in the royal chamber, and died without falling into corruption. And after much time they arose from sleep as an assurance of the resurrection of all men. Through their supplications, O Christ God, have mercy on us. Both now and ever and unto the ages of ages. Amen. For thou for our sake was born of a virgin and did suffer crucifixion of the one, and didst despoil death by death, and as God has revealed the resurrection, disdain not them which thou hast fashioned with thy hand. Show forth thy love for mankind, O merciful one. Accept the Theotokos who gave thee birth and interceded for us. Indeed thou our Savior, save of this very people. Deliver us not up utterly for thy holy name's sake, now that this is all thou thy covenant. And cause not thy mercy to depart from us. For Abraham's sake thy beloved, and for Isaac's sake thy servant, and for Israel's thy holy one. O holy God, holy mighty, holy immortal, have mercy on us. Holy God, holy mighty, holy immortal, have mercy on us. Holy God, holy mighty, holy immortal, have mercy on us. Glory to the Father, and to the Son, and to the Holy Spirit. Both now and ever, and unto the ages of ages. Amen. O most holy Trinity, have mercy on us. O Lord, blot out our sins. O Master, pardon our iniquities. O Holy One, visit into our infirmities for thy name's sake. What a mercy, what a mercy, what a mercy. Glory to the Father, and to the Son, and to the Holy Spirit. Both now and ever and unto the ages of ages. Amen. Our Father who art in the heavens, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our debts as we forgive our debtors. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from the evil one.
Thine is the kingdom and the power and the glory of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit, now and ever, and unto the ages of ages.
Amen. Spurning the corrupt things of this world, and accepting gifts of incorruption, though they died, yet did they remain untouched by corruption. Wherefore they arose after many years, bearing all unbelief to the wicked. When we faithful praise you today, laudation, let us stand in Christ. What a mercy, 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 what a mercy. What a mercy, 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 what a mercy. What a mercy, 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 what a mercy. What a mercy, 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 what a mercy. Thou who at all times and at every hour in heaven and on earth are worshipped and glorified, O Christ God, who art long suffering, plenteous in mercy, most compassionate, who lovest the righteous and has mercy on sinners, who call us all to salvation through the promise of good things to come. Receive, O Lord, our prayers at this hour and guide our life with thy commandments. Sanctify our souls, may chaste our bodies, correct our thoughts, purify our intentions, and deliver us from every sorrow, evil, and pain. Compass us about thy holy angels that guarded and guided by their array. We maintain to the unity of the faith and the knowledge of an unapproachable glory. For blessed art thou unto the ages of ages. Amen. What a mercy, what a mercy, what a mercy. Glory to the Father, and to the Son, and to the Holy Spirit, both now and ever, and unto the ages of ages. Amen. More honorable than the cherubim, and beyond compare, more glorious than the seraphim, who without corruption destruction, he had just directed out the word, the very day which fulfills, he will be magnified. In the name of the Lord, Father, bless.
The prayer of the Holy Father, the Lord Jesus Christ, our God, and mercy on us.
Amen. O Master, Lord Jesus Christ, our God, who art born suffering in the face of our transgressions, and was brought us even into this present hour, where he does sing upon the life-giving tree, and it make a way to paradise for the wise thief, and by death it's destroyed God. Be gracious unto us sinners, and thine unworthy servants, for we have sinned and committed iniquity, and are not worthy to lift up our eyes and behold the height of heaven. For we have abandoned the way of thy righteousness, and have walked in the desires of our hearts. For we beseech thy boundless goodness, spare us, O Lord, according to the multitude of thy mercy, save us for thy holy name's sake. For our days were consumed in vanity, rescue us from the hand of the adversary, forgive us our sins, and mortify our carnal mind, that pulling aside the old man, we may be clothed in you, and look for thee our master and benefactor, and that thus by following in thy commandments, we may attain to rest everlasting, where it is the dwelling place of all and every joys, for thou art indeed the true joy and gladness of them that love thee, O Christ our God, and unto thee to be sent that glory, together with thine unoriginate Father, and most holy and glory in thy creating spirit, now, never, and unto the ages of ages. Amen.
Blessed is our God, always, now, and ever, and unto the ages of ages.
Amen. O come, let us worship God our King. O come, let us worship and fall down before Christ our King and God. O come, let us worship and fall down before Christ himself our King and God. Bless the Lord, O my soul. O Lord, my God, who has been magnified exceedingly. Confession and majesty hast thou put on, who covers thyself with lightness with a garment, who stretches out the heaven as it were a curtain, who forth his chambers in the waters, who appointeth the clouds for his ascent, who walketh upon the wings of the winds, who maketh his angels spirits and his ministers a flame of fire, who establisheth the earth and the sureness thereof, which shall not be turned back forever and ever. The abyss like a garment is his mantle, upon the mountains shall the waters stand. At thy rebuke they will flee, at the voice of thy thunder shall they be afraid. The mountains rise up, and the plains sink down into the place where thou hast established them. Thou pointest a bound that they shall not pass, neither return to cover the earth. He sendeth forth springs in the valleys, between the mountains where the waters run. They shall give drink to all the beasts of the field, the wild asses will wait to quench their thirst. Beside them will the birds of the heavenly lodge, from the midst of the rocks will they give voice. He watereth the mountains from his chambers, the earth shall be satisfied with the fruit of thy works. He causeth the grass to grow for the cattle, and the green herb for the service of men, to bring forth bread out of the earth, and wine maketh glad the heart of man, to make his face cheerful with oil and bread, strengthening man's heart. The trees of the plain shall be satisfied, the cedars of Lebanon which thou hast planted. There will the sparrows make their nest, the house of the heron is chief among them. The high mountains are a refuge for the hearts, and so is the rock for the hares. He hath made the moon for seasons, the sun knoweth his going down. Thou appointest the darkness, and there was the night, when all the beasts of the forest will go abroad. Young lions roaring after their prey, and seeking their food from God. The sun ariseth, and they are gathered together, and they lay them down in their dens. But man shall go forth unto his work, and to his labor until the evening. How magnified are thy works, O Lord, in wisdom hast thou made them all. The earth is filled with thy creation, so is this great and spacious sea. Therein are things creeping innumerable, small living creatures of the grave. There go the ships, there the straggling thou hast made to play therein. All things wait on thee to give them their food in due season. When thou givest it them, they will gather it. When thou openest thy hand, all things shall be filled with goodness. When thou turnest away thy face, they shall be troubled. Thou wilt take their spirit, and they shall cease, and unto their dust shall they return. Thou wilt send forth thy spirit, and they shall be created, and thou shalt renew the face of the earth. Let the glory of the Lord be unto the ages. The Lord will rejoice in his words. He looketh on the earth, and maketh it tremble, and toucheth the mountains, and they smoke. I will sing unto the Lord throughout my life. I will chant to my God for as long as I have my being. May my words be sweet unto him, and I will rejoice in the Lord. For that sinners would cease from the earth, and they that work iniquity, that they should be no more. Bless the Lord, O my soul. The sun north is going down. Thou pointest the darkness, and there was the night.
how magnified are thy works, O Lord, and wisdom hast thou made them all. Glory to the Father, and to the Son, and to the Holy Spirit, both now and ever, and unto the ages of ages. Amen. Alleluia, 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 glory to thee, O God. Alleluia, 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 glory to thee, O God. Alleluia, 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 glory to thee, O God.
In peace, let us pray to the Lord. For the peace of our love and the salvation of our souls, let us pray to the Lord. For the peace of the whole world, the good estate of the holy churches of God, and the union of all, let us pray to the Lord. For this holy temple, for them that with faith, reverence, and the fear of God enter herein, let us pray to the Lord. Patriarch Kirill, for our Lord, the very most reverend Metropolitan Nicholas, first hierarch of the Russian Church abroad, for the venerable priesthood, the diaconate in Christ, for all the clergy and people, let us pray to the Lord. For our venerable father, the abbot of this holy monastery, our commanderite Seraphim, and all his brethren in Christ, let us pray to the Lord. This land, its authorities, and armed forces, let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, have mercy.
For the God-preserved Russian land and its Orthodox people, both in the homeland and the diaspora, and for their salvation, let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, have mercy.
For this monastery, for every city and country, and the faithful that dwell therein, let us pray to the Lord. Of the fruits of the earth in peaceful times, let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, have mercy.
For travelers by sea, land, and air, for the sick, the suffering, the imprisoned, and for their salvation, let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, have mercy.
If we can be delivered from all tribulation, wrath, and necessity, let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, have mercy.
Help us, save us, have mercy on us, and keep us, O God, by thy grace.
Lord, have mercy.
Calling to remembrance, our most holy, most pure, most blessed, glorious Lady Theotokos, ever Virgin Mary, with all the saints, let us commit ourselves and one another in all our life, and through Christ our God.
Thank you.
on my right hand in the hour there was none to know me. But after I leave, there is none to watch after my soul. I cried unto thee, O Lord, I said, Thou art my hope, my portion, not thou, the man of sin. I said unto my supplication, cry about me, Lord. You have leave me, you first give me the man upon your eyes. In my soul, I put you in a mission for finding me. The righteous shall wait for you to be coming until thou shalt be worthy. For this have I cried unto thee, O Lord, O Lord, in my voice. The thine is the attempt to the voice of my supplication. That's which my conditions, O Lord, O Lord, I trust in.
Would it be there's forgiveness? Come, let us go up with Jesus. To ascend his holy mountain. And there let us hear the voice of the living God, the all-originate Father, which through the divine Spirit bearing witness by a cloud in which you shine. And illumined mind, let us gaze upon light of your light.
I am sick and I patiently waited for thee, O Lord. My soul waited patiently for thy word.
My soul hath hoped in the Lord. Come, let us form a forest beforehand. Let us purify ourselves and faithfully prepare for divine entry into the dwelling place of the transcendent God, and let us receive the glory which the four chosen apostles have asked to behold mystically on altivers.
From the morning watch until night, from the morning watch,
let Israel hope in the Lord. Transform ourselves in the more exalted transformation. Let us prepare ourselves now for the morrow to ascend the holy mountain of God, beholding the glory of Christ which shineth for them mutably, more brightly than the sun, and illumined with the light of the Trinity. Let us glorify his condescension therein.
With the Lord there is mercy, with him is plenteous redemption. And he shall redeem Israel out of all his iniquities.
Dying in the blood of the flesh, O glorious one. Thou hast clothed thyself in the purple robe of divine grace. And is placed upon thy head the crown of life incorruptible, and bearing the trophy of the cross in thy right hand, as a scepter, O most wise martyr, the witness with Christ ever rejoicing.
Oh, praise the Lord, all ye nations.
Praise him, all ye peoples. Thou hast recognized, O Eusygnius, as an invincible warrior, for wielding the sword of the cross, thou didst go forth to do battle with the adverse foe, and didst tell him contending splendidly, and receiving the crown of victory from the world master and judge of the contest, who reigneth forever.
He hath made his mercy to prevail over us,
and the truth of the Lord abideth forever. By thine honored sufferings, of glorious athlete, Eusygnius, thou didst portray the honored fashion, and as a victor thou dwellest in the city on high, rejoicing with all the martyrs, and being deified by communion with the Godhead. Wherefore we celebrate thine honored and holy festival.
Lord, look now in the fifth cone.
Glory to the Father, and to the Son, and to the Holy Spirit, from now and ever, and unto the ages of ages. Amen. Come, let us ascend the mountain of the Lord to the house of our God, and let us gaze upon the glory of his transfiguration, the glory of the only begotten of the Father. Through light let us receive light, and exalted in the Spirit, let us hymn the consubstantial Trinity forever.
For joyous light of the holy glory, the immortal, heavenly, holy, blessed Father of Jesus Christ, having come to the setting of the sun, having beheld the evening light, we praise the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit, God. Need it is for thee at all times to begin with reverent voices of Son of God, Giver of life, wherefore the world hath glorified thee.
Let us attend, peace be unto all. Wisdom the prekeimen on the sixth tone. My help cometh from the Lord, who hath made heaven and the earth.
My help cometh from the Lord, who hath made the heaven and the earth.
I have lifted up mine eyes to the mountains, from whence cometh my help.
My help cometh from the Lord, who hath heaven and the earth.
My help cometh from the Lord,
who hath made heaven and the earth.
Vouchsafe, O Lord, to keep us this evening without sin. Blessed art thou, O Lord, the God of our fathers, and praised and glorified is thy name unto the ages. Amen. Let thy mercy, O Lord, be upon us according as we have hoped in thee. Blessed art thou, O Lord, teach me thy statutes. Blessed art thou, O Master, give me understanding of thy statutes. Blessed art thou, O Holy One, enlighten me by thy statutes. O Lord, thy mercy endureth forever. Disdain not the work of thy hands. To thee is due praise, to thee is due a song, to thee glory is due, to the Father, and to the Son, and to the Holy Spirit, now, never, and unto the ages of ages. Amen.
Let us complete our evening prayers of the Lord.
Lord, have mercy.
Help us, save us, have mercy on us, and keep us, O God, by thy grace.
Lord, have mercy.
That the holy may be perfect, holy, peaceful, and sinless, let us ask of the Lord.
Grant this, O Lord.
Angel of peace, a faithful guide, a guardian of our souls and bodies, let us ask of the Lord.
Grant this, O Lord.
Pray the remission of our sins and offenses, let us ask of the Lord.
Grant this, O Lord.
Things good and profitable for our souls and peace for the world, let us ask of the Lord.
Grant this, O Lord.
That we may complete the remaining time of our life in peace and repentance, let us ask of the Lord.
Grant this, O Lord.
For sending for our life, painless, blameless, peaceful, and a good defense before the dread judgment seat of Christ, let us ask.
Grant this, O Lord.
All these remembrance, our most holy, most pure, most blessed, glorious Lady Theotokos, never Virgin Mary, with all the saints, let us commit ourselves and one another and all our life unto Christ our God.
To thee, O Lord.
For a good God art thou, and the lover of mankind, and to thee do we send up glory, to the Father, and to the Son, and to the Holy Spirit, now and ever, and unto the ages of ages.
Amen.
Peace be unto all.
And unto thy spirit.
Let us bow our heads unto the Lord. And
to
glorified be the dominion of thy kingdom, of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit, now and ever, and unto the ages of ages.
Amen. You who live with the abundance of the virtues, let us proceed to the holy mountain, that we may behold the divine transfiguration of the Lord.
Mercy and truth are met together.
Righteousness and peace have kissed each other, shining forth today like the Son of the Martyr, before undergoing his sufferings, Christ showeth to the initiates of his mysteries the divine side of his divinity.
Blessed is the people
that knoweth true revelation, desiring to transform Adam's nature. Christ now ascended Mount Tabor, that he might disclose his divinity to the initiates of his mysteries.
And but now in the same tone,
glory to the Father, and to the Son, and to the Holy Spirit, both now and ever, and unto the ages of ages. Amen. O Christ God, who was transfigured in glory on Mount Tabor, and to show the glory of thy divinity to thy disciples, illumine us also with the light of the knowledge of thee, and guide us to the path of thy commandments. For thou alone art good, and lovest mankind.
Now lettest thou thy servant depart in peace, O Master, according to thy word, whom my eyes have seen thy salvation, which thou hast prepared before the face of all peoples, a light of revelation for the Gentiles, and the glory of thy people Israel. Holy God, Holy Mighty, Holy Immortal, have mercy on us. Holy God, Holy Mighty, Holy Immortal, have mercy on us. Holy God, Holy Mighty, Holy Immortal, have mercy on us. Glory to the Father, and to the Son, and to the Holy Spirit, both now and ever, and unto the ages of ages. Amen. O Most Holy Trinity, have mercy on us. O Lord, blot out our sins. O Master, pardon our iniquities. O Holy One, visit and heal our infirmities, for thy name's sake. Lord, have mercy, Lord, have mercy, Lord, have mercy. Glory to the Father, and to the Son, and to the Holy Spirit, both now and ever, and unto the ages of ages. Amen. Our Father, who art in the heavens, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our debts as we forgive our debtors. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from the evil one.
For thine is the kingdom, and the power, and the glory of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit, now and ever, and unto the ages of ages.
Amen. Let us go forth and meet the transfiguration of Christ, splendidly celebrating the fourth feast thereof. O ye faithful, and let us cry aloud, the day of divine gladness hath arrived. The Master ascendeth Mount Tabor to shine forth the beauty of his divinity.
Mercy on us, O God, according to thy great mercy, we pray thee, hearken and have mercy.
Lord, have mercy, Lord, have mercy, Lord, have mercy.
And we pray to our great Lord and Father's holiness, Patriarch Kirill, for our Lord, the very most reverend Metropolitan Nicholas, first hierarch of the Russian Church abroad, and all our brethren in Christ.
Lord, have mercy, Lord, have mercy, Lord, have mercy.
And we pray for our all-venerable Father, the Abbot of this holy monastery, our commander, Seraphim, and all his brethren in Christ.
Lord, have mercy, Lord, have mercy, Lord, have mercy.
And we pray for the silence authorities and armed forces.
Lord, have mercy, Lord, have mercy, Lord, have mercy.
And we pray for the God-preserved Russian land and its Orthodox people, both in the homeland and in the diaspora, and for their salvation.
Lord, have mercy, Lord, have mercy, Lord, have mercy.
And we pray for the blessed and ever-memorable founders of this holy monastery and for all our fathers and brethren gone to their rest before us, and the Orthodox here and everywhere laid to rest.
Lord, have mercy, Lord, have mercy, Lord, have mercy.
And we pray for mercy, life, peace, health, salvation, visitation, pardon and remission of the sins of the servants of God, the brethren of this holy monastery.
Lord, have mercy, Lord, have mercy, Lord, have mercy.
And we pray for the offerings and do good works in this holy and all-venerable temple, for them that minister and them that chant, and for all the people here present who awaited thee great and abundant mercy.
Lord, Lord, have mercy, Lord, have mercy.
For a merciful God art thou, the lover of mankind, and the need to return that glory to the Father, and to the Son, and to the Holy Spirit, now and ever, and unto the ages of ages.
Amen.
Wisdom.
Amen.
He that is and blessed, Christ our God, always, now and ever, and unto the ages of ages.
Amen. Establish, O God, the holy Orthodox faith of Orthodox Christians unto the ages of ages.
O most holy Theotokos, save us.
More honorable than the cherubim, and the unconfirmed more glorious than the seraphim, who without corruption gave us birth to God the Word, the very Theotokos, he ate and magnified.
Glory to thee, O Christ, God our hope, glory to thee.
Glory to the Father, and to the Son, and to the Holy Spirit, one now and ever, and unto the ages of ages. Amen. Lord, have mercy, Lord, have mercy, Lord, have mercy. Father, bless.
Christ, for true God, the intercessions of his most pure mother, through the power of the precious and life-giving cross, through the intercessions of the holy, glorious, and all-praised apostles, of the holy, great martyr, and the other Pantelemon, of the holy martyr Eusygnius, and of the holy and righteous ancestors of God, Joachim and Anna, and of all the saints, have mercy on us and save us, for he is good and the lover of mankind.
Amen. I greet Lord and Father Kirill, most holy patriarch of Moscow and of Russia, our Lord, the very most reverend Nicholas, Metropolitan of Eastern America and New York, the first hierarch of the Russian Church abroad, the all venerable abbot of this holy monastery, Archimedes Seraphim, the brethren of this holy monastery, and all Orthodox Christians, these are, O Lord, for many.